Good morning, good morning, good morning. It is Linda at your service again this morning. How you guys doing out there in YouTube land this morning? Guess where I'm at? I am in the strawberry patch getting ready to pick some strawberries today. Yep, I wanted some strawberries. I think last year we missed them, so this year we're out here on time. So we're gonna try to fill up this bucket right here. See this bucket? Fill that bucket up right there. That's an $18 bucket, a gallon bucket, supposedly. It don't look like a gallon to me, but that's what they call a gallon bucket. So, and then after that, I might make me some strawberry jam. If not, I'm going to eat all the strawberries I want, if not make no jam. Okay, we're going to mince the pick in here now. So, I'll get back with you guys later. Okay.
Hey guys, this is what I got so far. They're pretty. In spots, they're pretty. My rose is kind of skimpy. Yeah, I'm skipping over them too. Yeah, we're skipping over the small ones, getting the big ones. This bucket gonna be filled quick, but anyway. I might do some strawberry shortcake.
See that right there, what she got in her hand? That's a giant one there. It's a nice size one. Her bucket almost full. It is full, just gotta top it off. Mine's already full and topped off. Pretty strawberries. Beautiful. Look. Ooh, that's a nice one too.
Girl, and we getting some good strawberries out here. Look at these berries. Berries. All kind of berries. Out here in this berry patch.
My bucket is filled. So what do y'all do? Do y'all go pick strawberries during strawberry season? And if so, what do y'all do with y'all strawberries? Do you just eat them? I usually make strawberry jam and put some in the freezer. But my freezer don't have room in my freezer. My freezer is small. So I don't have enough space in my freezer to get enough to put in there. So what I'll probably do now is just probably make some strawberry jam. Can't hardly see me. Make some strawberry jam and eat the rest, I guess. I seem like I need to get another bucket. But anyway, I'll decide on that in a few minutes. Hey y'all, how you doing? I am back again. We made it home from the strawberry patch. I stopped to Walmart and got some cube steak for dinner, so I'm getting ready to throw that together. I got the strawberries. I didn't do but one bucket of strawberries. That one that I showed you, that tastes pretty good. Is that a bug on there? Ew. I'm trying to find a pound cake recipe so I can make some strawberry shortcake. Thank you. been out of town. I'm just getting back home on yesterday, which was Thursday afternoon. Where home is where my mom lived, where I'm from, rather. My cousin passed away, so I went to see my aunts and my cousins. Spent a little bit of time with them and came back home on yesterday, so I have not been in the house. Kitchen in a couple of days, so I got wiped down a little bit. Okay. Get this dried off so it'll be. Clorox burned my eyes.
That don't even go up there.
Let me see what these potatoes so mess. We'll put that there. Big frying pan. I think I'm gonna do this cube steak, mashed potatoes, and asparagus. It's already got that on hand. Have to peel some potatoes. Chopped up there good. This is kind of thick. Thank you. Yeah, I did wash this cube steak. I rinsed it off. If you're wondering, you had to put the camera down so you can see me. Let's see. It wasn't chopped up that good, no way. It's still pretty much together. So I think I'm gonna have to pound it some more anyway because it's thick. I don't want to wash it too much. I got to see what kind of steak it is. So it's cube steak, but I don't really know the name of the cut, which it don't have it up there. Just says cube steak. Okay, let's see how I'm gonna do this now. Let's see what happens. Maybe I should have got some meat tenderizer for these here. That side still ain't tenderized. See if I can get two more pieces in here. Thank you. This stuff get you to sneezing, boy. Mm. Here we go. Excuse me. The grease is hot over there. It's the frying pan get hot on your eye. Okay, and I get some potatoes and peel them once I get the steak on. Season the rest of it, man. So season the rest of the steak and get it going.
little quiet today, y'all. Got a whole lot going on today. I'm gonna leave you on this tape here. Gotta cook them again, so it really don't matter, but I do want a little bit better than that. Whew. Let's get these potatoes on. Thank you. there.
Put y'all back over so you can see them onions I just put in here.
A lot of them.
Put a little bit more seasoning in there. Put on the sea this salt. Yeah.
Asparagus. Okay, I'm going to wash these asparagus, sis, and put them in here. Potatoes are boiling for the mashed potatoes, and onions are caramelizing down. And I'm getting ready to do the asparagus. Just going to cut the ends off right now. Let me go over here. Cut these ends about right here. Put them in the sink so I can wash them. Thank you. see the top of this pan. I might have to get another pan for that because this pan may not be deep enough, and then I don't have a top to put on it. So let's see what I got down here. Yep, get another frying pan. Switch pans here. A little bit. This pan is deeper, that way it'll hold the gravy when I put it in there. Okay. Put some aluminum foil at the bottom of this pan. And this asparagus because I don't want it to stick. I don't have a lot to clean up either. Asparagus, I'm just gonna drizzle a little bit of olive oil. These onions are about ready for me to put the meat on top of it, but let me get these asparagus ready first. I'm going to put on this garlic powder, a little bit of Himalayan salt. Garlic powder. A little bit softer. And these are about ready. Okay, I put water in here. You can use chicken broth or any kind of broth you want. I guess I just use water today. I always use water mostly for my stuff like this. Test the gravy out when it comes to a boil. See how much more seasonings I need to put in there. I'm gonna set these on in the oven. Turn that down there, come to a boil. Let it simmer for a few minutes. And then go to my next step. Let that go for a minute or two. This is about ready. Mashable right there. Can't put that up in the board on. Let's use this. It's coming right along, y'all. I don't think I'm gonna have to make the gravy. It's making its own gravy. Probably gonna put once that finished cooking, I don't think I'm gonna have to do nothing to that. Turn it down a little bit more on simmer. Let that cook for a minute. Make sure it's tender. Get a pan, make these potatoes. Got my asparagus in the oven. Potatoes, I think you're done. Let me pull the water off of you. I don't think I can use that for this because that's.
on a little mash them, cook them long enough. Try this Himalayan salt in here. Let's try it. Canned milk is good for these potatoes, y'all, mashed potatoes, but right now, I don't know. This is a quick meal. I guess if I use the can, it would be quick too, but I don't feel like opening the can. It's lazy, let's hit it in the day. We'll put a little bit of garlic powder in here. Might be a lot, whatever. Make them too loose and I don't make them too thick. Okay, asparagus is coming along good in the oven. Let's give this a taste test and see if we got enough salt. Almost, I can taste the garlic powder good. Not enough salt. Let's try this one. And milk. All right, this is it. Could use a little bit of milk, but I don't want them too mushy, so I'm gonna leave them alone. Canned milk always make the best mashed potatoes, but I just use the jug milk today. Had to catch up on that another time. Fresh mashed potatoes. They are all done. Taste and make sure I got enough gravy, enough seasonings in it. It ought to be pretty tender. Turn the eye off on that. I'll taste that in a minute. Let me check these asparagus and see. Taste this stuff here and see what it tastes like. I almost definitely gotta get me some more light in here. It's good. It's done. And I'm done with it. I did do some mashed potatoes. Steak and gravy, cube steak, mashed potatoes, and asparagus. Quick meal. These are thin, so they're probably already done. That's it. Then for tonight. And there it is. All done. You guys, I'm gonna end this video right now. For now, I'm done cooking. I want to do a cake, but I'm tired, so I'll come back and do a cake maybe tomorrow. I just want to do a pound cake to go with the strawberries and whipped cream that I got. Okay, so I guess I will see you guys when I come back on my next video. Don't forget to hit the thumbs up button, subscribe to my channel. And I will see you guys on the next video. Girl is tired. See ya.